James Webb's marvellous first images undoubtedly charmed the whole world. However, on one of its pictures, something extraordinary has been spotted, yet nobody seems to talk about it. Join us in today's video as we analyse the first images by the telescope, including the one that changed everything. With the help of an instrument called a spectrometer, the James Webb telescope probed deep into the universe and brought the WASP-96 exoplanet to our focus. It wasn't a new discovery, though. The planet was first spotted in 2014, and it's one of the 5,000 exoplanets that exist in the Milky Way galaxy. The WASP-96b can be found in the Phoenix constellation, 1,150 light-years away from our Earth. Due to its extreme temperatures of around 1,000 degrees Fahrenheit, the planet is nicknamed Hot Jupiter. The WASP-96b rotates around its own star once every 3.4 days. Its diameter is 1.2 times bigger than that of Jupiter, but ironically, this gas planet is less than half the size of Jupiter. Thanks to its sophisticated components, the James Webb telescope needed only 6.4 hours to calculate the dimensions of the WASP-96b and reveal several signs of water and evidence of haze and clouds. These dimensions were calculated by the Webb's near-infrared imager and slitless spectrograph, and scientists tell us that they are the most precise measurements ever calculated by a space telescope. The observation, which reveals the presence of specific gas molecules based on tiny decreases in the brightness on precise colours of light, is the most detailed of its kind to date, demonstrating Webb's unprecedented ability to analyse atmospheres hundreds of light years away, NASA said in a statement. The next image released by NASA shows the Southern Ring Planetary Nebula that was previously hidden from researchers. Alternatively referred to as the NGC 3132, the planetary nebula are basically shells of gas and dust particles expunged into space from dying stars. Official records show that the three-dimensional NGC 3132 is approximately 2,500 light-years away from our planet. As expected, the James Webb telescope captured the Southern Ring Planetary Nebula in ways that scientists didn't expect, revealing details of the star's later life. The image of the Southern Ring Planetary Nebula showcases the array of distant galaxies in the background. As per NASA, it was catalogued by two efficient cameras aboard the James Webb telescope, including the near-infrared camera, which also helped capture the image of the SMAX 0723. The mid-infrared instrument also plays a huge role in the discovery. Some stars save their best for last, NASA wrote in a blog post. The dimmest star at the center of this scene has been sending out rings of gas and dust for thousands of years in all directions, and NASA's James Webb Space Telescope has revealed for the first time that this star is cloaked in dust. Next image by Webb is the Stevens Quintet. It is a cluster of five galaxies located 290 million light years away. As per official reports, four of these galaxies are closely attached to themselves, with NASA saying they're seemingly locked in a cosmic dance of repeated close encounters. The Stevens Quintet, or NGC 7319, was first discovered by French astronomer Edouard Stéphane in 1877. It houses a supermassive black hole that is 24 times bigger than the size of our Sun. In the same vein, it produces the same light energy as 40 billion suns. The telescope allowed scientists to better understand the composition, temperature, and movement of gases, which ultimately give them an insight into the lifespan of stars. Interestingly, the Stevens Quintet image, as released by NASA, is a composite of 1,000 different image files, with the end product rated 150 million pixels. With its powerful infrared vision and extremely high spatial resolution, Webb shows never-before-seen details in this galaxy group, NASA explained after the release. Sparkling clusters of millions of young stars and starburst regions of fresh starbirth grace the image. Sweeping tails of gas, dust, and stars are being pulled from several of the galaxies due to gravitational interactions. Another astonishing image captured by Webb's near-infrared camera is the Karina Nebula, otherwise known as NGC 3324, or Cosmic Cliffs. It's located about roughly 7,600 light years away. Essentially, the Karina Nebula is a luminous region that houses several glittering young stars, some of which are several times bigger than our Sun. This three-dimensional image looks more like a ragged mountain under the moonlight. The peak of the cliff, as per reports, is about 7 light-years high. Aside from all the complexity and numbers that the Karina Nebula comes with, we can't help but ignore the sheer beauty of the cliff and the elements that surround it. Space watchers often describe the region as void and empty, but pictures like the Karina Nebula have shown that we were indeed wrong. Rather than emphasize the vastness and emptiness of the world beyond, this image highlights the elegance and beauty buried in space. Here is the SMAX-0723, a cluster of galaxies located within the extremely distant southern constellation of Volans. The picture, as it appears on your screen, is a complex image formed from several other images shot during a period of 12 and a half hours, giving scientists an infrared depth that was impossible to attain with the Hubble Space Telescope. Macquarie University's professor Richard de Grigis admits that the picture blew him away at first sight. The image released by NASA shows the SMAX-0723 exactly as it was some 4.6 billion years ago. Thousands of galaxies, including the faintest objects ever observed in the infrared, have appeared in Webb's view for the first time. This slice of the vast universe is approximately the size of a grain of sand held at arm's length by someone on the ground. The combined mass of this galaxy cluster acts as a gravitational lens, magnifying much more distant galaxies behind it. Webb's NERC cam has brought those distant galaxies into sharp focus. They have tiny, faint structures that have never been seen before, including star clusters and diffuse features. Researchers will soon begin to learn more about the galaxy's masses, ages, histories, and compositions as Webb seeks the earliest galaxies in the universe. If you look at the bright, white elliptical galaxy at the center of the photo and all the other white, smaller galaxies throughout the image, you see the ones that are responsible for the lensing effect. Bound together by gravity in a galaxy cluster, they are bending the light from galaxies that appear in the vast distance behind them. Dark matter and the overall mass of the galaxies behaves like a cosmic telescope. Hence, it creates magnified and contorted images of individual galaxies that are sometimes mirrored. Clear examples of that can be found in the prominent orange arcs to the left and right of the brightest cluster galaxy. Every individual galaxy is shown twice in one arc, and these are the ones that have been lensed. Webb's image has fully revealed their bright cores, which are filled with stars, along with orange star clusters along their edges. However, this does not apply to every galaxy in the picture, as some of them are only stretched and not mirrored. Others appear scattered by interactions with other galaxies, leaving trails of stars behind them. The telescope proved to be a game changer when it comes to details we can observe through this domain. Very diffuse galaxies appear like collections of loosely bound dandelion seeds aloft in a breeze. Individual pods of star formation practically bloom within some of the most distant galaxies, the clearest, most detailed views of star clusters in the early universe so far. The galaxies in this scene that are farthest away, the tiniest galaxies that are located well behind the cluster, look nothing like the spiral and elliptic galaxies observed in the local universe. They are much clumpier and more irregular. Within these galaxies, scientists of the field can measure the masses and ages of the stars thanks to Webb. This might lead to more accurate models of galaxies that existed at cosmic spring when galaxies were sprouting tiny buds of new growth, actively interacting and merging, and had yet to develop into larger spirals. Ultimately, Webb's upcoming observations will help astronomers better understand how galaxies form and grow in the early universe.